Okay. Welcome. I will do this presentation in English. I'm Peter Martin, and I will tell you something about how features can end up in Joomla. So if you have a feature request, if you want to have new stuff in Joomla, you can participate in it as well. This is my background. I live in Nijmegen, the Netherlands. I have my own company. It says dba.nl, but the color is lost over here. Oh yes, thanks. Recently I created a new component, which is called dba8 site dev. It's for free, you can download it, and it's a sort of checklist that you can use to start new Joomla websites. So you install it, you can install the checklist, and with everything you have to do about the website. I organize a Linux user group in Nijmegen and Open Coffee, and I'm also a volunteer in Joomla. And in this presentation, I will tell you something about the category item counter, which was included in Joomla 3.5. And do you know what the category item counter is? Shall I show it first? So in Joomla, if you go to content articles, you can go to the categories. And when I talk about the category item counter, it's about these options. So if I go to news, I unpublish one. I go back to categories. I can see there are two published and two unpublished. So if I want to publish this one, I just can click it. And all the filters are set. So it's easy to find stuff that is published, unpublished, etc. So this is the category item counter. And I tell you something about how it came into existence, and also how the Joomla development process works. So if you have your own ideas, you can help out. So the origin of this nice feature, does anyone know where it all started? This is a Nijmegen central station. It didn't start over here. This is Den Bosch central station. This is the train, the bus in Eindhoven. This is an airplane in Eindhoven, which went to some place in Europe. Here it is. And I can help you a bit. Look at this sign, it says Acropolis. Does anyone know where it is? Sorry? You think so, but it was just a parking place. It was in Nice last year. At 3 o'clock in the afternoon, then it started, this new feature. It was a French conference. My French not really good. So in the afternoon, there were only French talks. And I was talking with this fellow. His name is Marc de Chèvre. He's from Belgium. And he was complaining a bit. Yeah, it's a pity that the Joomla category manager doesn't have any article counter anymore. And lesson number one, when you go to conferences like these and you have ideas, share the ideas. Like, yeah, it would be good if Joomla would have this or that. If you share your ideas constructively, people can do something with it. So don't do it on Twitter. It's not constructively. So in the past, this is Joomla 1.5, you had two counters, an active and a trashed items. So the unpublished ones were not here. But this was just a counter, you couldn't click on it. But Marc de Chèvre, he really loved this because you can easily see where all your trash is and clean it up. So me, with my stupid head, said something like, oh, it's not really that difficult to build in, is it? Just an SQL query. If you know a bit about SQL, you can just add a counter in it. Easy does it. So, but before that, it was the first day at the end of the conference. Lesson number two, have fun. And that's what we did in the evening. I don't know if you know Roland Dalmulder. He was also there, and Victor Vogel as well. And with Roland, I went to this pub. It's a French pub somewhere. Next day, I showed some photos to those local people from Nice. And they were looking at it. Oh, did you go there? Yeah, we don't go there because it's a bit rough pub with bikers, etc. And yeah, it was. But, well, we had fun anyway. We drink two beers. Oh, actually, four. Two per person. So, but at 12 o'clock, I was already back in the hotel. And I thought, yeah. I was still thinking about this feature. Ah, maybe I can just build it in, show off tomorrow to Mark. Look what I did yesterday. So I looked at it and I thought, what did I do? It was not really easy to build in because Joomla has a well-kept secret. It's the com category. You all know the category manager in Joomla. But if you compare it with the old category manager of Joomla 1.5, you will see that the category manager of articles in Joomla 1.5 was in the com content. And if you go to the banners, it had the code of the category manager was in the banners because it was only a category manager for banners. And someone, and then it's easy to count stuff. Because if you are managing the categories of articles, you can also look at how many articles it is, but you also have banners. And then you have to count in another table. So someone really created a new feature called com categories, which was a generic component that is the category manager for all your content. And you can use it in your own extensions as well. So if you look at the URL structure of your Joomla website, and if you are in the article manager, you will see com_content. And if you click on categories, you will see that the structure changes like com categories. So you are going to com categories and it says extension is com content. It's really difficult to see. So let's go. Where is it? My mouse. Ah. There's my mouse. So what you can see here, it says extension is com content. I mean, with articles, you can see here, content option is com content. So Joomla knows, oh, you want to go to com content, and the view is articles. And when you click on the categories, you can see that the URL, maybe can you see the bottom of this page? That com categories extension is com content. So the content, it knows that you are doing that. And if you go to components banners, it says com categories extension is com banners. So you are using the com categories and that you pass the extension what you want to categorize in the URL structure. So it's really nice because you know who is using com messages in Joomla, the messaging system? No one. Well, me neither. But if you go to articles category manager, then it says option is com categories, extension is com content. And if you change com content for com_messaging, you will start the category manager for messages. It doesn't work, but you can start it anyway. And if you want to use this in your own extensions, you have to create a form for it. And in the form, you say something like type is category, and then the extension is your own component name. And then you can just create extensions for your own component. So it was really difficult for me to start, because you have banners, news feeds, web links, etc. I didn't know how to start. And in this case, the best thing you can do is limit the scope of your problem. So next day I was talking with Victor and Roland about, I said this and I looked at the code and it's really difficult. And then Roland said something like this, you have to maybe only do it for com content. So I limit my scope and I said, okay, I created a query somewhere and I said, if the extension is com content, then count all, do all the counting stuff. So then I could create it just for com content. It was not good, but it was working just for one part in Joomla. So what happened next? I think I should describe Joomla's development process a bit. First of all, are you familiar with Git, GitHub? Yeah? Okay. So Joomla uses Git as software versioning control. And it's really nice because you can it's distributed, and in the past it was not. When Joomla just started, they used SVN, and only a couple of people could make changes in Joomla. Now everyone here, even we, can make changes. I mean, we go to a website called github.com, and it has a repository called Joomla/JoomlaCMS. And if you want to change something, you change it, and you send a pull request, and I will get to that in a minute. So it was this made it really better to improve Joomla. It made it easier. So if you go to GitHub, you have PRs and you have RTCs. PRs means pull requests. That means, okay, hey Joomla, I created some code. Could you please pull this my code into the Joomla core? That's what the pull request is. Maybe it does not happen, but it's a request, a pull request. And RTC means some code has been pulled to Joomla, or it's ready to get into the Joomla core, but you need 3 successful tests. And if you create something, like maybe you just change a language variable somewhere, because that's also possible, or maybe you want to change the order of a couple of menu items. If it's in the core code, you can change it on GitHub and do a pull request. But if you want to do a pull request, it needs to be tested. So you should be prepared to test yourself. And in my case, Mark de Chèvre, who said, yeah, it should be easy to do it. I mean, it would be nice if Joomla had this feature again. And I said, okay, if I create this feature, would you like to test it? He said, yes. And in the evening, he was, oh, what did I say? He didn't know how to test. But at the end, everything was okay. Has any one of you participated in a Joomla bug, Pizza Bugs and Fun event? Yes, okay. Yeah? You know what Pizza Bugs and Fun is? You just help out, test stuff. You ate some pizza and you have fun. And in this case, someone created a patch tester component. And if you install it in Joomla, it's really easy to test patches, to test the PRs. So if you want to help out testing, you install Joomla. You install the testing data. And you install Joomla, not the latest version like 3.6.2, but you install it from GitHub. So you get the next version, which is at the moment 3.6.3. And it's called staging. When you install it, you install the patch testing component. And in the patch testing component, you can load all the pull requests. Then you read the description of what the problem is and how to test it. You test it, and if you see you can produce the problem, you know, okay, the problem exists. Then you apply the patch, and if the patch is applied, you test again. And if the problem has been solved and you don't see any weird stuff at other places in Joomla, you can say, okay, I tested it okay, or maybe I tested it not okay. And you write a small report, just a couple of lines of code, and then you uninstall it and you can do the next. If something in Joomla has been solved, like a bug, it might come in the next Joomla version. So small things that are bugs and will be in 3.6.3, and if you create a new feature, it might end up in a new version like 3.7. I think, does anyone of you develop yourself? Yeah? Do you use Git yourself? Oh, you should. It's really, really awesome. And you can do it in public, like using GitHub, but you also have Bitbucket, and you can do it in a private repo, and you have your code somewhere, all the changes. It's marvelous. And if you want to help out in Joomla, you can go to github.com and make small changes, and you can create a pull request of that. But if you have multiple files, like maybe you have 3-4 files where you have to change small things, then I think this workflow is better. So what I always do, one time I created a fork of Joomla. So I went to the Joomla on github.com, Joomla CMS. I created a fork, and you have to do it only one time. And the fork is called Joomla CMS in my own repo. My GitHub name is PE7ER. So if I go to github.com/PE7ER/JoomlaCMS, I can see my copy of Joomla, my fork of Joomla. And the next thing is, I want to have it on my local machine. So what I did, I cloned it with Git clone, and it was on my local machine, and then I could start developing. But if I create a clone today, maybe in 3 days' time, new code has been added to Joomla itself, and it's not in my repo, so I have to synchronize it. And to synchronize it, what you can do is, on your laptop, on your computer, I have my own repo on GitHub, and this is my computer. I created an upstream. So I told to GitHub on my computer, okay, I would like to have Joomla CMS as upstream. And what I then did is, I did a pull request of all the stuff from Joomla, which is on my laptop. And then I push it to my remote. So Joomla and my remote will be the same. When I create new stuff, I create for a branch, which means just a name for the feature you want to develop. And when it's ready, you push it to your own repo. And when it's on a repo, GitHub will say, hey, I see you added something to your clone or to your fork of Joomla. Would you like to create a pull request for this? And then I say, okay, you can do that. And you have to write some testing instructions, because it needs to be tested before it will be submitted. And it's really important to write clear testing instructions. And that means you don't have to say something like, in an article you have to do this. No, you have to say something like, go to content, article manager, create a new article, and in the parameters, change this to that, or something like that. So you have to be really explicit. Otherwise, people have to think a lot, and they think, okay, this might be really difficult, I skip it. So you create some testing instructions, and with clear instructions, it will be tested. First, Travis will test it. And Travis is an automated process on GitHub. It's just software that looks at your code. It looks if your code is okay, if the code style is okay. If you develop yourself, I recommend to install PHP CodeSniffer on your IDE. So before you submit it, you test it on your computer already, and you will take a lot of errors out of it. Then you need two real people, to test it. And those people can go to issues.joomla.org and help you with testing. And if you have two successful tests, then it will be RTC. But to make it more easy, it's better to create screen dumps of what you want to do. So in my case, I said, okay, I have a new feature for Joomla. Before you apply this patch, the category manager will look something like this. And after you apply the patch, it will look like this. And as you can see, it looks really ugly, because you can't click it, because the feature was not developed then. It was just a counter first. And okay, when it's on GitHub, people can look at it and test it. And I think maybe an hour later, I had my first response to my new patch. Somebody said, does anyone know, what's the hater template? Who knows what it is? What is it? Yes. Yes. And I thought, hey, hater, but I'm doing this for ISIS, but you have to test it for that one as well. But I said, okay, I would first like to finish it when it's working in ISIS, then I will change it for a hater as well. The next command said, yeah, it looks horrible, the alignment looks bad. Yeah, I know. I just want to have this feature first, and then when it works, then I will do something with the alignment, or maybe someone else can do it for me, because that's not my cup of tea. And then someone said, Travis is not happy, could you try to fix the bugs? And Travis is really not easy to please. For instance, if you have a variable, and you have another variable like first name and last name, and you put a dot in between, and you do echo, it will put your first name and last name just after each other. But Travis won't be happy, because Travis says, the code style of Joomla says, you have to put a variable, space, dot, space, variable. So if you don't add the spaces between, you get an error already. So it's really, really strict. So at the end of the conference in Nice, I was sitting there, and you probably know him, Victor Vogel. And I was just making the last changes, and it looked quite okay. Not really okay, because it was I had only published unpublished trashed, and then somebody said, yeah, what about archived? Yeah, I never use archived. Yeah, other people might. So, okay, let's add archived as well, and make it smaller. So this was how it looked. And after the event, I was a bit happy, and Mark was happy as well, because the feature was working a bit, but only for com content. And I even tried to please the person who said, oh, did you think about hater? Because it was working there as well for com content. So it was nice, but not perfect, because it was only working for com content. And I wanted to make it more generic, because generic is better. But I didn't know how to do it. And there I have lesson number 7, dare to ask. Even people who have really high knowledge of Joomla, they don't know everything. So it's not funny, you just ask stuff. If you don't ask it, you never know it. So in my case, I asked people, okay, I want to make this feature more generic, where should I start? And some people said something about, yeah, if you look at the com content, you have the article manager, the category manager. And I knew this already, because I showed it in the beginning, that you can't use it there. But what it does is you have a left menu in the article manager. If you go to articles, you have a small menu which says articles, categories, and featured. And I think the media manager. And everything that's over there, it's done with the helper file of Joomla. And if I have some time left, I will show how this helper file looks like. So people helped me with this part. I was able to extend a query object. This is a bit difficult, and it's really difficult to read. So if you want to, yeah, maybe afterwards you can look at the presentation online. But what I did was, I just added some stuff, like a column header in a view. So I said something, okay, if a property underscore exists, this item, and this was, I think, the first column which is published, or whatever, then it should create a new column with a button on top. And later on in the same file, I would add stuff like the number and also filters. Like it says filter category ID and filter published ID and filter level. These are used. So if you click on the news, unpublished, you will go to the the component name, in this case, com underscore content, and you go to the filter category of news, and published is -1 if it's unpublished. Zero. So this is how you go to a specific part of it. But I got problems here. Some components of Joomla didn't behave like I wanted. Like everything uses filter is unpublished. I mean filter published, but the banner banners uses filter state. So I had to create another pull request to get the banner component also working with my feature. And you can teach your own components. If you write your own components, you can use this feature as well to let your own components count your own items. What you should not do, is use count distinct. I did it, this is how I programmed it, but you should not use it. And I come to that in a couple of sheets. And so you have, for every state, you have another query, but it gave some problems. I created this feature when Joomla 3.4 point, I don't know, was out, and I hoped, well, maybe it might be in the next 3.4.6 or 3.4.5, I don't know. But it was a new feature, so I had to wait for 3.5. And just a couple of days before Joomla 3.5 was released, there was a problem. I think if you have an easy website, a small Joomla website, it might the database might look like this. So it's you have a good order, you can find a lot of stuff. I think some sites might look like this, and not our sites, but our client sites, I think. We are really tidy, so this is not our sites. But what if you have sites like this? Sites with 100 categories and 85,000 articles. There was one person who has this kind of site, and he said, yeah, there's a problem. Instead of just a couple of 1 second, it takes 40 seconds to get a list of categories. And it was because I used distinct. And so the performance really increased a lot. Decreased, so it got worse. So the count distinct had to get rid of it. Fortunately, someone else did a pull request to change this. So my pull request that I was able to create because all the people helped me was improved by other people who looked at the pull request and said, okay, that should be better. So it became faster. And they did it by just removing stuff and putting stuff in other places, like in the view. And because of this, you even can get rid of it with a template override if you want to. So the count distinct state query got removed, and instead of that, I think Nikolai from Italy, he changed it like this. And in this case, this is just a small counter. It became much faster. This is just a couple of things. So if you look at the new count feature, there was another problem. I think Victor Vogel, I'm not sure, reported this. If you have more categories or sections or something, it doesn't handle it well. So I think he did a pull request for this as well. So this is it. I will give a small summary and then I can show you some code if you like to. First of all, if you have ideas, share them. If you think that Joomla can improve in some ways, I know Joomla can be improved. Just talk with people and please don't say Joomla should do this, Joomla should do that, but it should be really great if Joomla would have this feature. I think that Joomla, if Joomla has this feature, then it will be improved a lot. And maybe I can help, but I can't program myself, but I know how to describe the feature and yeah, just share your ideas. And of course, have fun. And when you do stuff and it's really difficult, just limit your scope and do it in parts. Be prepared to test. And if you write something yourself, if you change something yourself, create nice, clear testing instructions and preferably with screen dumps. And if you don't know anything, something, just ask, and other people will help you out. Okay, this presentation will be online, and I would also like to thank everyone who helped out. I think maybe 10, 15 people helped out with testing, with patching my patch, with giving my ideas about how to improve it. If you would like, I can show some code of Joomla and how this menu works and how everything works. So I will do that. Even kijken, this one. I have to change the resolution of my screen a bit so I can have it like this. It's working? Okay. So first of all, I'm using an IDE called PHPStorm, but if you have something like Sublime or another text editor, Node++, everything is good. Especially if you have code highlighting and if you can install something like CodeSniffer. So I will open my Joomla.de. And I will go to Joomla itself. This is the backend of Joomla. And if I go to, I told you about the messaging system, components, messaging. There is no category manager in this. But if I go to the URL, I copied com messaging. I go to the category manager of the com content. So if I change com content for com messages, I will use the category manager for com messages, which does not exist. Now I have the option in the messaging, which is called messaging categories. It does not exist, and it's just because of the URL structure. I can create a new message. New menu, a new category for messaging. But because the messaging system is missing some stuff, there is no save button here, so I can't save it. But it's really funny that you can start it. So let's go back to the category. Articles, categories, features. This is specifically, com content, but it's a shown in the com categories. And if I go to com banners, I have the same. I go to the com categories, extensions, banners, and this is made because of a helper file. And let me show you. I can go to really slow. Yes. So in Joomla you have the administrator, there you have components, and in components you have, for instance, com content, the content manager. It has a helper file, and the helper file is called content.php. And here it says add submenu. And if I do something like this, and I do something like And if I go to this, and if I refresh, it should have a new option called Hello Joomla Day Germany. And it's also highlighted because I have to change the feed name in something like this. Oh, hello entry. So I have a new feature in Joomla. It doesn't work. If I click it, it will go to the category manager. But this is how I edit the counter. So I use the helper file of components. And if I go to GitHub, this is, I have no internet. How can I go to the internet here?
Media campus has that.
Ah, yeah. What's the password? Sorry? Oh, yes, you type. Only the Danke. So this is GitHub and this is the Joomla repo, but the fork I created. And what you can see is this branch is 306 commits behind, which means I have to update it first before I start stuff. And if I go to the original like this, here I can see that 2 days ago there was a commit added to Joomla. And let's assume that you want to change something in Joomla. For instance, what can we do? If you go to the article manager and in the article manager you have the batch option. And if I do like this, batch, and you don't like the order of set language and to move to copy, etc., you can change it. And as long as you can make Joomla more consistent, like options on the same place all the time, you can just try to propose it. And what you do is something like, for instance, I go to the administrator because I saw something in a view. I go to the components. I go to com content. And in com content, I go to views. And I go to the article edit view in the backend. And because I noticed something is wrong. For instance, this is the backend. And I notice something is wrong. I want to have, instead of title, I want to have something else here. Like, where's the title? This is the backend, isn't it?
Could be.
Yeah, I don't want to change the language because that's not a good example in this case. I just want to add something like, do it like here. Content, controllers, views, article. Now let's do it in the article list. And I have default, and I want to do something like this is a real improvement for Joomla. So if I go to here, here it says something which you can see. This, and if I want to add this improvement to Joomla, I can just go to Joomla itself. I go to the file, it's in views, articles, template, default. There, 5 months ago, it was changed. And if I want to edit it, I just do like this, edit. I go to here. And if I do save, which I won't do, but if I do save, I have the possibility to add a description about why this is an improvement for Joomla and how to test this improvement. And then it will become a pull request and other people can see it as well. So this is how you can change stuff in Joomla, the easiest part. And when you create a pull request and you go to Joomla CMS, it will be listed on the page pull requests. And here you can see this. This is a new feature, and this new feature has a language change as well. If it will be included in Joomla, it will be in Joomla 3.7. These are all the things that have been suggested. But if you see a bug in Joomla, you can use issues, or go to issues.joomla.org. And you just create something, a new issue. You don't have to add code, but the testing instructions would be marvelous to add. And people who can code can look here and think, okay, I can maybe change this. I can add code for it to solve it. Are there any questions? Okay. That's it. Thank you. Thank you very much.